Hello friends. Welcome to Study Time. Today current affairs for competitive exams 2021. Sixth review meeting on CAPEX held. Union Minister for Finance and Corporate Affairs Nirmala Sitharaman held a virtual meeting with senior government officials to discuss the infrastructure roadmap ahead on the 29th of June 2021. This was the sixth review meeting by the finance minister. During the meeting, capital expenditure CAPEX plans of ministries and measures to expedite infrastructure investment were discussed. Glacial Lake Atlas of Ganga Basin released. The Glacial Lake Atlas of Ganga Basin was released on the 29th of June 2021 in a virtual event. The present Glacial Lake Atlas is based on the inventoried glacial lakes in part of the Ganga River Basin from its origin to the foothills of the Himalayas covering a catchment area of 247,109 square kilometers. The atlas is available on the Bhuvan portal of NRSC, ISRO, India WRIS portal, and NHP website of DAO. Sukoon initiative launched. SDRF 1st Battalion's 24x7 mental health helpline Sukoon was inaugurated at its headquarters in Srinagar on the 29th of June 2021. Sukoon is a mental health helpline initiative toll-free number 1-800-1807-159 to offer guidance to persons who are experiencing anxiety, depression, stress, etc. It has been launched in collaboration with Mission Youth J&K and Tourism Department. Manipur CM announces cash award for Olympians. Manipur Chief Minister has announced that all five Olympic-bound athletes from the state will be handed financial support of 25 lakh rupees and will be given more cash awards if they return with medals. The gold medal winner will be given a cash prize of 1.20 crore rupees and the silver medalist will get Rs. 1 crore. The bronze medal winner will get 75 lakh rupees. Association of cloudbursts with forest fires. A recent study has found a connection between the formation of the tiny particles, the size of a cloud droplet on which water vapor condenses, leading to the formation of clouds and forest fires. The quantity of such particles is called the cloud condensation nuclei (CCNs). Scientists from Himwati Nandan Bahuguna Garhwal University and IIT Kanpur jointly measured the activation of CCNs. SERB DST partners with Intel India. A first-of-its-kind research initiative called Fund for Industrial Research Engagement, FIRE, was launched on the 29th of June 2021. It was launched by the Science and Engineering Research Board, SERB, in collaboration with Intel India. It will increase research opportunities in the space of artificial intelligence, AI, machine learning, milliliter platform systems, Internet of Things, IoT, etc. Brazil to suspend Covaxin vaccine deal. Brazil's health minister has announced that the country will suspend a US$324 million contract to buy 20 million doses of Bharat Biotech's Covaxin. The contract for the acquisition of the Covaxin vaccine was signed by the two sides in February 2021. The vaccine doses were never sent to Brazil, as the National Health Surveillance Agency, Anvisa, denied import requests for the vaccine. RBI imposes penalties on four cooperative banks. The RBI has imposed penalties on four cooperative banks. 112.50 lakh rupees fine has been imposed on Andhra Pradesh Mahesh Cooperative Urban Bank for contravention of certain regulatory directions. A penalty of 62.50 lakh rupees has been imposed on the Ahmedabad Mercantile Cooperative Bank, Ahmedabad, 37.50 lakh rupees on SVC Cooperative Bank, Mumbai, and 25 lakh rupees on Saraswat Cooperative Bank, Mumbai. NCERT to develop curriculum frameworks. The government has asked the National Council for Education Research and Training, NCERT, to develop separate national curriculum frameworks, NCFs, for school, early childhood, teacher, and adult education. This is a part of the process to implement the new national education policy. The four NCFs will be crucial for developing new textbooks and designing the pedagogy. Agritech projected to grow to $30 billion. The $370 billion agriculture sector is expected to undergo a complete transformation in the coming years. Agritech in the country will see significant investment and is projected to grow to a $30 billion market by 2025, with a sales of produce, inputs, and digitally enabled logistics as key segments, according to a new report. Indian agriculture, ripe for disruption, by Bain & Company. HDFC LTD acquires 8.42% stake in Ansal Housing. HDFC LTD has acquired an 8.42% stake in Ansal Housing Limited by invoking pledged shares of the company following loan repayment default. Ansal Housing reported a turnover of Rs 116.93 crore for the year ended the 31st of March 2020 and its net worth as of that date was 214.12 crore rupees. It has already completed many development projects in Delhi, Mumbai, Lucknow, Meerut, and Ghaziabad. Pernod Ricard to set up venture fund in India. Pernod Ricard will launch a venture fund in India that will invest in and mentor smaller companies, startups, and adjacent businesses such as restaurants. Pernod is the maker of Absolut Vodka and Chivas Regal Scotch. India is Pernod Ricard's largest market by quantity and the third biggest contributor to gross sales and revenue globally. J&KLG Manoj Sinha launches HAUSLA. Jammu and Kashmir Lieutenant Governor Manoj Sinha on the 29th of June 2021 launched HAUSLA. It is a comprehensive program for catalyzing women entrepreneurship at Kashmir International Convention Center KICC in Srinagar. The first batch of the 5-month program with 100 women entrepreneurs on board will start from July 2021. A loading operation inaugurated. The loading operation on the maiden voyage of Coastal Shipping Service Green Freight Corridor 2, from Kochi Port to Bepo and Azikkal ports, has been inaugurated. The service will connect Kochi, Bepo, Azikkal and later Kollam port will be added to this service. The commodities that would be shipped include rice, wheat, salt and cement unloaded at Kochi from Gujarat. Capacity of fortification of rice to increase. The center has expedited the capacity of fortification of rice to increase from 15,000 MT to 3.5 lakh MT by incentivizing and creating awareness among rice millers. The Depth of Food and Public Distribution has approved a pilot scheme on fortification of rice and its distribution under public distribution system for a period of 3 years beginning in 2019-20 with a total outlay of 174.64 crore rupees. Collections of literature presented to Norov. India's ambassador to China Vikram Misri presented a translated version of 10 peerless collections of modern Indian literature to Shanghai Cooperation Organization Secretary General Vladimir Norov on the 29th of June, 21. This is in realization of the commitment made by PM Modi at the Bishkek summit that India will translate 10 great creations of Indian regional literature into Russian and Chinese. Banking service to be introduced in Ladakh. In Ladakh, cooperative banking service with micro ATMs where both deposition and withdrawal of cash can be availed by the users will be introduced in remote areas. This was decided during a meeting under the chairmanship of MDJ&K State Cooperative Bank Kazi Sawa in Srinagar. The meeting aimed at facilitating cashless transactions of sale proceeds of fertilizer by using POS machines. Seema Punia qualifies for Tokyo Games. In the National Interstate Athletics Championships in Patiala, 2018 Asian Games bronze medalist discus thrower Seema Punia has won a gold medal. Seema bettered the Olympic qualification mark of 63.50 meters. Meanwhile, Aditi Ashok qualified for her second Olympic Games. In gymnastics, the Asian Championships bronze medalist in vault, Pranati Nayak, earned a quota for Tokyo Olympics. World Bank provides $300 million MN to Bangladesh. The World Bank will provide $300 million to Bangladesh to help about 75,000 poor and extremely poor rural people across 20 districts. The World Bank financing under the Resilience, Entrepreneurship and Livelihood Improvement RELI project will help boost the rural economy in about 3,200 villages. 90% of the beneficiaries will be women. Enforcing Contracts Portal launched. The Department of Justice has launched Enforcing Contracts Portal. It aims to promote ease of doing business and improve the contract enforcement regime in the country. The portal will provide easy access to latest information on commercial cases in dedicated commercial courts of Delhi, Mumbai, Bengaluru, and Kolkata. The portal will also provide access to a repository of commercial laws. SEBI approves a proposal. Securities and Exchange Board of India SEBI has approved a proposal to introduce a framework for accredited investors in the Indian securities market. It will be a class of investors who may be considered to be well-informed or well-advised about investment products. Accredited investors may be individuals, Hindu undivided families, HUFs, partnership firms, etc. Picasso painting recovered after 9 years. A painting by Pablo Picasso that was stolen 9 years ago during a heist at a Greek gallery has been recovered. Picasso's woman's head had been found along with a 1905 painting of a windmill by Dutch artist Piet Mondrian. The Picasso painting, a portrait of a woman in his signature cubist style, was given to the National Gallery by the artist himself back in 1949. Atmanirbhar Krishi app launched. Atmanirbhar Krishi app was launched by the Office of Principal Scientific Advisor to the Union Government on the 29th of June 2021. The app has been developed to equip farmers with actionable agricultural insights. Data related to soil type, soil health, moisture, weather, and water table were aggregated and analyzed to generate personalized insights related to crop selection, water needs, etc. Rural Development Min releases a compendium. Minister of Rural Development Narendra Singh Tomar has released a compendium. It is on best practices relating to how Deendayal Antyodaya Yojana National Rural Livelihoods Mission is addressing gender issues. The unique feature of this scheme is that poor women form self-help groups and their federations provide financial, economic and social development services to their members. PM Grameen Kalyan Anna Yojana extended. The Union Gov has now extended the Pradhan Mantri Grameen Kalyan Anna Yojana for 5 months, that is from July to November 2021. Further allocation of 198.78 lakh MT food grains has been made under PMGKAYIV. Under PMGKAY3, the Food Corporation of India has supplied 77.42 LMT free food grains to all 36 states and UTs so far. 23 states and UTs have lifted full allocation for May-June 2021. MoU signed between Indian Navy and Bell. And MoU has been signed between the Indian Navy and Bharat Electronics Limited. It has been signed for the creation of a joint technology incubation forum TIF. The TIF will spearhead mission mode development of deployable products under the government's Atmanirbhar Bharat initiative with the involvement of industry, academia and startups. Center allocates grant to Jharkhand. The center has allocated 2479 crore rupees grant to Jharkhand under Jal Jeevan Mission. In Jharkhand, out of 58.95 lakh households in 29,752 villages, only 7.72 lakh households have been provided with tap water connections. In August 2019, at the time of launch of Jal Jeevan Mission, only 3.45 lakh households had tap water supply. Now 4.27 lakh households have been provided tap water connections. NITI Aayog releases a study. NITI Aayog has released a comprehensive study on the not-for-profit hospital model in the country. The study provides insights into the operation model of not-for-profit hospitals. The report was released by V.K. Paul. The report revealed that the for-profit hospitals account for 55.3% of inpatients, while the not-for-profit hospitals account for only 2.7% of inpatients in the country. Asia's longest high-speed track inaugurated. Minister of Heavy Industries and Public Enterprises Prakash Javdekar on the 29th of June, 21 inaugurated Asia's longest high-speed test track located in Pithampur, Indore. The National Automotive Test Tracks, NATRAX, facility measures 11.3 kilometers in length and will facilitate automotive and component testing for automobile companies. The track is the longest in Asia and the fifth largest in the world. Cipla gets DCGI nod to import Moderna vaccine. The Drugs Controller General of India has granted permission to Cipla to import Moderna's COVID-19 vaccine for restricted emergency use in the country. Moderna's vaccine will be the fourth COVID-19 jab to be available in India after Covishield, Covaxin, and Sputnik. Moderna is the first internationally developed vaccine and permission has been given for restricted use. IIT Madras develops drone algorithms. Researchers at IIT Madras have developed algorithms for drones to help study how fire behaves in space stations, shuttles and satellites. According to the team, a multirotor microgravity platform can also simulate reduced gravity environments similar to Moon and Mars, thereby recreating those conditions on Earth for experiments. Assam Police launches three initiatives. The Assam police has rolled out three initiatives that will strengthen its capabilities in handling cybercrime and ensuring speedy delivery of services to the people. Director General of Assam Police Bhaskar Jyoti Mehant has inaugurated the Cyber Forensic Lab cum Training Center, the Citizen Financial Cyber Fraud Reporting and Management System and distributed cybercrime first responder kits. Sambhu Nath appointed chairman of IFUNA. A former judge of the Allahabad High Court, Justice Sambhu Nath Srivastav, has been appointed chairman of the Indian Federation of United Nations Associations. It is a non-profit organization to promote the objectives of the United Nations and its specialized agencies. Sambhu Nath succeeds Mukul Sangma, former Chief Minister of Meghalaya. Delhi Metro bags an award. The Delhi Metro has bagged an award from the Japan Society of Civil Engineers for its high-quality infrastructure development projects under Phases I-3. The Outstanding Civil Engineering Achievement Award is for the year 2020. This award is given to highly selective showcasing projects in the development of civil engineering technology across the world. Orissa Gov to set up district industry. Orissa government has decided to set up district-level industry and investment promotion agencies, DIPAs, in different districts. This was decided in a high-level meeting headed by Chief Secretary Suresh Chandra Mahapatra. It was decided that DIPAs would be managed by three professionals under the direct supervision of the respective collectors. Manish Matam, Head of Payments, WhatsApp. WhatsApp has appointed former Amazon executive Manish Matam as a director to lead the growth of its payments business in India. As director WhatsApp Payments India, Matam will focus on enhancing the payments experience for users. He joins WhatsApp from Amazon, where he spent close to 7 years as director and board member of Amazon Pay India. India, South Korea conduct military exercise. An Indian Navy warship carried out a military exercise with a South Korean vessel in the East China Sea on the 28th of June 2021. Indian Navy's indigenous ASW Corvette in Skilton deployed in the Far East undertook Navy partnership exercise with Republic of Korea Navy ship Rokes Gyeongnam. It was aimed at enhancing interoperability and facilitating exchange of best practices with partner navies. NCW launches 5-day training program. The National Commission for Women, NCW, has launched a 5-day project series training program of protection officers in addressing domestic violence on the 28th of June 2021. It will address the specific needs of protection officers in responding to survivors of domestic violence. It was started in collaboration with Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration, LBSNAA. India commits 4,500 crore rupees to Bhutan. India will contribute 4,500 crore rupees to Bhutan's 12th five-year plan, following delegation-level talks headed by PM Narendra Modi and his Bhutanese counterpart Lotte Shering. Bhutan's 12th five-year plan runs from 2018 to 2023. India will also provide a transitional trade support facility of 400 crore rupees over a period of 5 years to strengthen bilateral trade and economic linkages. International Day of Parliamentarism, the 30th of June. The International Day of Parliamentarism is celebrated every year on the 30th of June. It's the date on which the Ipuwinter Parliamentary Union was founded in 1889. The day was established in 2018 through a United Nations General Assembly resolution. In 2021, the IPU members will mark the day with the IPU campaign I Say Yes to Youth in Parliament. The end. Thank you for listening. Please like, share, comment and subscribe.